हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, वी आर इन एक्सरसाइज 3.2 ऑफ क्लास 6। द क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट इज व्हाट इज द सम ऑफ एनी टू ऑड एंड इवन नंबर। सो नाउ वी स्टार्ट दिस। सो हियर इन द ऑड नंबर, एज यू आर अवेयर अबाउट द ऑड नंबर्स लाइक 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, सो ऑन, दीज आर द ऑड नंबर। एंड व्हाट अबाउट द इवन नंबर लाइक 2, 4, 6, 8। The divisor of this number is 2. Here you cannot divide this number by 2. So if you take the addition of any 2 like 1 plus 3 is 4, 3 plus 5 is 8. If you take 3 plus 9, it is 12. So now you carefully observe this result. In result, we are getting even number. Okay. So if you add any 2 number, then result is even number. Got that? And what about the even number? 2 plus 4, answer is coming 6. Okay. If you do 6 plus 8, answer is 14. 4 plus 6 equals to 10. Now you observe the result here, 6, 14 and 10. So in result, we get even number. So you can write here, result is even number. So here, this is the answer of the question number 1. And after that, we will see the second question. Now here, we are in the question number 2. State whether the following statements are true or false. Here the first is A part, the sum of 3 odd number is even. As you already learn what is odd number, what is even number. So here the sum of 3 odd number, I am taking simple number like 1, 3 and 5. Sum means addition. Now you do here calculation, 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 1, 9. The answer is coming in odd number. But here what is given, the sum of 3 odd number is even. But we are getting odd results, so it is false. First answer is false. Second one, B, sum of 2 odd numbers. So I am taking the odd number 1 and 3 and 1 even number, I am taking 4. So doing calculation, it is coming 8 and it is even only. So the second one in this case, true. I am taking one more example for cross checking. Sum of 2 odd numbers, suppose I am taking odd number 5 and 3. 1 even number, I am taking 6. So 6 plus 5, 11. 11 plus 3, 14. So 14 is also even number. So our result is true only. Then product of 3 odd number is odd. I am taking 3 odd number 1, 3, 5. Product means multiplication. So answer is 15. I am taking one more example like 5, 3 and 7. Okay, so 7 into 3 is 21. So 21 into 5. So it is 105. Now you check both the number, they are nothing but odd. So our answer is the product of 3 odd number is odd. So it is true. Question number D. If the even number is divided by 2. If the even number I am taking 6, if it is divided by 2, the quotient is always odd. So here the 3 will be there because 2 into 3 is 6. But if I take other number 12, 12 divided by 2, answer is coming 6. And 6 is what? Even number. And here it is always odd. So it is false. It is not true for all the cases. All prime numbers are odd, but you know prime numbers start with 2 and 2 is what? Even. 2 is even number and here the statement is all prime numbers are odd, so it is false. Question number F. Prime number do not have any factor, but the prime number having 2 common factor 1 and the second is number itself, so it is false. Sum of 2 prime number is always even. 2 prime number is always even. Suppose I am taking And here the important thing is sum of two prime number is always even. Suppose you are taking prime number 3 and 5, it is 8. But if you include 2 and next number is 3, then it is 5. Okay, so here 5 plus 3, 8, it is coming even. But if you include 2 there, here it is odd. So it is nothing but false. Next question number H. 2 is only even, is the only even prime number. It is 2 because 2 is even. And after that, whatever the numbers coming like 3, 5, 7, 11, you observe they are the odd ones. So it is true. Question number I. All the even numbers are composite number. But 2 is what? Prime number. 2 is prime number. So this statement is false. The product of two even number is always even. So here you take two even number like 4. Product means multiplication. Two even number. Suppose I am taking 2. So it is 8. Suppose I take 6 and 4. So it is 24. So answer is coming in even. So it is true. So I hope, friend, you understood the question number 2. After that, we will go to the next question. Now we are in the next question. Question number 3. The number 13 and 31 are prime number that we know. Both these numbers have the same digit 1 and 3. Find such pair of prime number up to 100. So here I have already written in advance the prime number up to 100. So total numbers are 25. Okay, because in one column I have written, sorry, in one row I have written 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 into 4 is 24 plus 1. So total 25 prime numbers are there. So here we have to track some number like here 13 and 31. Okay, the number 13 and 31 are the prime number. Both these number have same digit. Find such pair. So here we circle 13 and 31. So this number that is already present in the answer. So we have to find some other pair. So now if you consider after 13 onwards, here only one digit is there, so there is no need to check. 11, two digits are same. So you have to check here 17, this number, and then 71 is also present. So I am make circle here. So one pair I got 17 and 71. Next one is 19, but 91 is missing. 23, but 32 is not the prime number. 29, 92 is not prime number. 37, then you check 73. So yes, it is present. So next one is 37 and 73. So this is the easiest way of solving this. First in advance, if you get this question in exam, you have to write first prime number and then check. Next pair we will do from ascending order only 41, but 14 is not prime number. 43, 34 is not a prime. 47, 74 is not a prime. 53, then 35 is also not prime. Then 59, then we will get 95. 95 is also not present in the list. And here 61, but 16 is not a prime. Then here 67, but 76 is a even number, so it is not prime. Then 79 is there and 97 is also present. Here 83 is there, but 38 is not a prime. 89 is there, but 98 is not in the list. So these are the pair that we got. Okay, so this is the answer of question 3. Fourth one, write down separately prime and composite number. Prime number and composite number, which is less than 20. You have to write the number less than 20. This statement is important. So first we will do prime number. It start with 2, as you know. Then after 2, 3 is there. After 3, 5 is there. Then 7 is there. 9 is not a 8 and 9. These are not the prime because 9 is 9 number you can divide by 3. 3 is a divisor for that. And next one is 11. Then after that 13 is there. Then 14, 15, these are not prime. Then 16 is also not there. 17 is there. and 19 is there. Remaining number you write in the composite list. So the list of composite numbers you write here, 4, then 6 is missing, 8 is missing, 9 is missing in this list. Then after that 8, 9, 10, 11 is there, so you write here 12, 13 is there, so you write here remaining 14, 15, 16, then here 18. They are asking less than 20. So these are all the composite numbers. So I hope, friend, you understood this question. So our next question is question number 5. What is the greatest prime number between 1 and 10? So first you have to calculate what are the prime number between 1 and 10. So as you know, it start with 2, then next is 3, next is 5, next is 7. And after that 8 is also not prime, 9 is also not prime. So here the greatest prime number is 7. So your answer is 7. Okay. So in question number 6, first part of the number is 44. So here, according to the question, express the following as a sum of 2 odd prime. So here we cannot include 2 because 2 is even. So 2 odd prime you have to include and do their sum. So first one is 44. Break into the two part. So if I break and take, first one is 37, second will be 7 because their sum is 44. You can take any two number, there is no restriction for that. This answer is varied from one student to another. So 37 plus 7 is 44. So it means that this is the sum of 2 odd prime. Here B part, there is a 36. Again you can break this number. First number, if I consider 31, second will be 5 because 31 plus 5 is 36. So this is what the sum of 2 odd primes. So these odd primes are 31 and 5. 24. So in the 24, if I take the first one, 19. Second one will be 5. So 19 plus 5 is 24. So these two number, 19 and 5, these are the odd prime. In case of 18, suppose if I break into 11 and the second will be then 7. So 11 plus 7 is 18. So these two numbers are odd prime. So in this way, this question was quite easy. Seventh one. Write three pair of prime number whose difference is 2. Okay. So difference should be 2 in between prime number. If I take 5 and 3. So 5 minus 3, the answer is 2. So the first pair is 5 and 3. Because their difference is, because if you take their difference, it is nothing but 2. Okay. Second pair, if I take 7 and 5, so their difference 7 minus 5 is 2. Third pair, if I take 13 and 11, so 13 minus 11 is 2. So these are the three pairs whose difference is 2. So this is the answer of seventh one. And after that, we will go to the next question. So our next question is question number 8. Which of the following numbers are prime? So this question is very simple. 23, as you know, it cannot be divided by other numbers. It can be divided by only two numbers, 1 and itself, but cannot be divided by others. So it is prime number. 51, what do you think if you try with 3? So 51 divided by 3. So here 3 ones are 3. So remainder will be 21. If you use 7 here, remainder will be 0. So it is a divisor of 3. Okay, so it is not a prime number. 37 ultimately prime number. 26 is a even number, so not a prime. So here, which of the following numbers are prime? So you can say 23 and 37 are the prime number. Question number 9. Write 7 consecutive composite number. Composite means they are not prime. Consecutive means continuous order, which are less than 100, so that there is no prime in between them. So we want 7 consecutive composite number which is less than 100. So while solving this, first you have to write all prime number up to 100. So I have already written, there are total 25. Then here you have to calculate 7 consecutive composite number. So you can check from each pair. So according to me, from 89 to 97, 7 composite numbers are there. यू जस्ट ट्राई देयर इन बिटवीन 89 एंड 97. इट इज 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96. So if you check, these are composite number, these are not prime. 90 not prime, 91 is also not prime, 92, 93 also, it is a divisor of 3, it can be divided by 2, 95 can be divided by 5, and it is divided by 3. So these are all composite numbers. So the answer of this question is this one. So write 7 composite number less than 100 so that there is no prime. So this is the answer of this question. Next one is question number 10. Express each of the following as a sum of 3 odd prime. We cannot include 2. So first one is 21. So here the sum of 3 odd prime. So 21 you can break into first 2 part. So first number I am taking 3. So next will be 18, because 18 plus 3 is 21. Then I want to break 18. 18 I want to break 11 and 7, because 11 plus 7 is 18. You can, it is not like whatever I am doing, you should do the same procedure. So 3 number, if you do their addition, 3 plus 11 plus 7. So it is what? 21. So here we express in the sum of 3 odd prime. Second one is 31. So this number can be break. First I am taking simple number 3. So next one will be 28. Then you can also break that 28 into 2 parts. Suppose if I take 117, next one will be 11. So now you do their addition, 3, 17 and 11. It will come 31. So this is what? The sum of 3 odd primes. 53. 53 you can break it out. So first if I take 3, next will be 50. Now you have to break 50 into 2 part. If I take 37, next will be 13, because their addition is 50. So it is written as 3 plus 37 plus 13, because it is equal to 53. So these number, these are the odd prime. 61. 61 can be written as 3. If I take first 3, next number will be 58. 58, if I take here first prime number 53, next will be 5, because their addition is 58. Now 3 plus 53 plus 5, it is 61. So these 3 numbers are odd prime. So this answer you can solve according to you. This answer is varied from one student to another. So I hope, friend, you understood all the questions of this exercise. Thanks for watching. Thank you. So now we are in the next question, question number 11. Write 5 pairs of prime number less than 20 whose sum is divisible by 5. Okay, whose sum is divisible by 5. So first, while solving this, you have to note it down, all the prime number less than 20. So these are the prime number. And then we have to find 5 pair which are divisible by 5. So my first pair is 2 and 3. Because if you do their sum, okay, if you solve 2 plus 3 equals to 5, because you know this number is divisible by 5. Next pair is, this is my first pair, and second pair is 7 and 3, because 7 plus 3 is 10. This number is divisible by 5. Then third one is, third pair what you can take, here it is 11, but other number is not there. Here 13 is there. 13 and 7, it is 20. So my third pair is 13 and 7, because 13 plus 7 is 20. 20 is divisible by 5. Then next one is fourth one. Now here in the fourth one, if I take 17 and 3, so it is 20. 17 plus 3 is 20, which is divisible by 5. Now only one is remaining. So here 19 is not possible, because 19, here it is possible, 19 if you add with 11. 19 and 11. So you do 19 plus 11 equal to 9 plus 1, 10, 1 carry, here it is 3. So it is divisible by 5. So finally we easily got the five pair. So these are the five pair whose sum, whatever the sum is coming, these sums are divisible by 5. So this is the answer of question number 11. And I hope, friend, you understood this. Our next question is question number 12, filling the blanks. Okay. So in A part, a number which has only and only two factor, as you know, it is known as a prime number. If a number has only two factor, that is 1 and itself, that is what the prime number. Then B, a number which has more than two factor, that is known as composite number. The number which has two factor is known as a composite number. Okay, first one is prime number. Here you should write after prime, you should write number. So first one is prime number, second one is composite number. One is neither prime nor composite number. Okay, the smallest prime number is 2, that you are already aware. The smallest composite number is 4, because 1 is not a prime, not a composite. 2 is what? 2 is a prime number. 3 is also prime. So the first one, 4th, is a composite number. And the smallest even number is 2. 2 is the smallest even number. So here we completed this exercise. If you have any doubt, just comment me. Thanks for watching. Thank you.